A hot tip for setting up a creative business. So the tip is this. In setting up your business, if you are a creative or setting up a creative business, there are two sides to this coin, the execution side and the structural side. The execution side is where you have the manpower, people who are going to do the work. It's pretty much the doing of the business. While the structural side is the structure behind the doing of the business. So the execution side will be artists, talents, graphic designers, people who are generally going to do the work. Then on the structural side are the people who make sure you still keep doing the work, from HR to admin to head of operations to the executive producers and business administration. Yeah, most of the seemingly boring guys. In a creative business, these two sides of the coin help to make sure you exist. And even based on my experience before we started Shorts Media, the two sides tend to have friction occasionally. Those of you in advertising and communication agencies, you know what I mean. Marketing department sucks. So yeah, there always seems to be that friction between the two arms of a creative business. But those who are able to succeed are those who understand that everybody is fighting for the same thing. The marketing guys want to make sure that that business comes into the company, so that you guys can keep on doing what you love doing. That's for the creative side. And of course, the creatives want to make sure that the work that they churn out is beautiful, is wonderful, is loved by they themselves and the general public, and that's so that they can have that sense of fulfillment. But what usually happens is a sort of compromise. You have to understand, especially when dealing with client projects, that you are not the one you are creating this for. It even goes beyond creating it for the client themselves. You are creating it for the clients, for their customers. Yeah, so it's pretty much like a double-edged sword. But the people on the structural side tend to understand the numbers and just generally making sure the business exists, and people on the execution side make sure that things get done. So when there is harmony and synergy between these two parts of a creative business, the sky is the limit. Unless you run out of clients and projects, and maybe stuff like COVID-19 happens. But I digress. That's just a little tip for you who is looking to start your own creative business. Even if you are a freelancer, just bear in mind that it's good to always think of the structural aspect. Get your structural side in order so that you are free to create and do what you love. So please don't forget once again to subscribe, hit that notification bell so that you'll know the next time I upload, and send some inspirational goodness in your face eyes. Please follow me on Instagram. Please follow me on Twitter. I'm not overly active on Twitter, but you can follow me. Who knows? I might drop a gem or two. And yes, of course, do connect with me on LinkedIn and also on Facebook. I'm trying to be more active on Facebook, but I am mostly on Instagram. So see you guys on the next one. It's gonna be a good one. It's going to be a good one. I think that take is good. Okay. Here's a tip. Hot tip for setting up a creative studio. Okay, so the